Hey, 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 good people of the world. Gun Gage. Now it's D1 Fan. The proper world we live in, there is another one. I'm a genius and you're the strongest of all. Yes, out of the blue, some insane scientists have released a superpower person. Well, and what did this evil scientist do? Have you fight a giant robot? That character is dressed rather queerly. Is that at least? Probably nothing wrong with that. Naturally, it is a suntan lotion boy with the pink hair. Has some of the best ability powers in the game. Unless he drowns. Because that's how you do it. And here is a thing of note. He only has a simple dodge roll. So compared to Stayer, he is a bit on the slow side. His thing is a submachine gun and a range indicator. And a radar as well. Unlike the other character, this one is an android, so the android pick up fuel as health. And these here power. This is a power cell, so one of his ability is a time stop bullet. Another one is just a bullet, a ring, and a beam. They all do the job wonderfully. A big difference between D and the others is the enemy configuration is also completely different. It's like, seriously, so many jellyfish. So many jelly. It must be noted that it is very easy to think of the PlayStation as a low graphical fidelity and all of that, but that's where art direction and competency comes into play. So, according to the information the game provides, there is a grand total of 100 flowers, or 99 or something like that. Ah, here is a door that is closed because D is not supposed to do that. For example, flowers, here's a floating flower bed with a flower hidden inside, under it. Just like here is a wonderful little silly puzzle. How would you trigger whatever you have to trigger here? Simple! Shoot the flowers! Shoot the flowers, then shoot emblems. That for some reason. And platforms come out of the ground. Also more jellyfish. And another waifu for people that like scales and long legs. Wait, that's not scale, that is shitin or whatever you, however you pronounce it. Yes. Run and gun. While rolling very slowly. And then fight another boss. Right. As far as a boss goes, this one is very basic. It's kind of cool looking meat cleaver mecha stone golem creature. That will make you even stronger. Get rid of the beast. For my own sanity's sake, I will just ignore the zigsaw puzzle. Zigsaw. Sure, it leads to loot, but that's just not worth it. Yes, and as usual, jumping is not very easy to do. As it is a fairly unpolished experience. However, it's still sort of fun in a simplistic way. There is all possible to get a couple of hours of gameplay out of this little bastard. Especially if you want all the unlocks. It is some galleries and a which is a gallery, and if you get all of them, some sound test. Followed by a infinite energy to all. Which is about as broken as it sounds. but also extremely fun. Then you can go through the whole game just murdering everything. And after all, there is no excuse. And since there is a different layout this time, I managed to get a flower I haven't picked up before. Naturally, some creatures are more proactive in murder. Some power pickups are also only person related. So for example, here around here is a flower that only one character can collect. However, that flower is also quickly gonna get run over by one of those creepy crawlers. If one do not pay attention. So things like the evil jellyfish. But they're just evil jellyfish, so one should not worry too much about them in the first place. In fact, the only certain thing about them is they are hostile, they float, and they're blue. Dabba dee. Dabba da. Naturally, there is always a way or two to exploit the less fortunate creatures of this crepid place. Also, the insufferable yellob is anything but nice to actually run into. And of course, leave it to me to waste a perfectly good opportunity to use just take away 2/3 of its health with one button. As far as the murder moth go, I give you 5 out of 10. Actually, 8 out of 10. You are slightly more interesting than a moonlight butterfly. Also, you blow up your blowing up is very satisfying. I cannot deny that. No secret bonus, no damage bonus. It'd be hard to get secret bonus once you have collected all of them. Like wipe out all the beast. Naturally, this character starts with only having to fight monsters. Which is quite a contrast to other ones. It also makes everything to fight much more straightforward. I mean, it's a bunch of butterflies. There's not exactly rocket science to fight these fools. Hermie, you're a fool. I guess it takes one to know one. Now stop glitching out on me, you monster mongrel. Miscarriage of... of design. Naturally, level and up with the boss. It is another giant beast. This one has always been very weak, so also straightforward. Dodge or die. And actually hit it with a special attack when you try to use it. And yes, it is possible to beat everything without taking damage. Beautiful, perfect. Ooh, no damage bonus. Excellent. This will confuse Empire. Destroy the power plant. Like I have mentioned earlier, there is an excuse plot. That is the norm for these sort of arcade games, is that the plot is always minuscule. Or should I say, the plot is always, there is a setting, and then there is a couple of words, and a little text blurb followed by... Mm. Followed by a level that is building the rest of the scenery. So you have the character telling a little bit of the story. The story, a little bit of the story being a blurb. Some of it just through the scenery. And the rest is random bullshit, really. And duct tape and spit. Also, there's a flower up here, so it incentivizes the player to, which is me, to actually do both versions of the boss, which is the top version and the bottom version. Bleh. Is actually writing on the side of the vehicle. As usual, there is no visual indicator of the flower or anything else. I just simply know it's here because I've seen it. And because the game also has a tally of the flowers. Oh, you are the strongest! You're like, yeah, boy. Which brings me right back to the train level. Which means his boyo begins a completely different place. It means flower. And a bunch of morons meandering around in zoots, burning alive. Naturally, it's a train level. That means the radar is really handy. This is an example of getting as much out of this experience as possible. You gotta love how on a hovercraft. A character is basically just a Terminator looking fellow that is also completely two-dimensional. Why that thing had two giant missiles? Anybody's guess. It also has a pistols on the side for no apparent reason. That is also just a two-dimensional sprite texture. Because reasons. And that man with a jetpack, for some reason, has a freezing gun of sorts. Can freeze if you're not paying attention or too slow to turn. Due to this being a train ride, dodge rolling is dangerous. And very slow. Not really like the rest of these perps. It's the same experience. Apparently, you can shoot the arms of the boss as well, but generally, you just keep aiming at the face and it works. Yes, and if you go up high, you cannot dodge the beam, and if you go low, if you're not doing enough damage, it will reach up to you and start stomping on you. Defeat the evil bringing power of the Ravna. I have no idea how they even know what that thing is called. See, here is a clever one. There's a flower that cannot be reached now. Because it took too long. You evil empire bastard. You're running out of flowers. This one was not a hard flower, it's just this robo boy is smaller than the rest. It is a clever way to hide an object. Yes. Turrets. My one true enemy. No dudes standing there. That is very... And yes, those turrets are just very irritating. And there we go, each run takes roughly around an hour. This is supposed to be the evil Ravna. In all honesty, I am not compressed. Those flames will never not be irritating. Boom. Yeah. And then the boss dies. Yes, it goes out with a boom. Well, of an ending sequence, and if you get a high score, you might even write in your own name. Has been sealed, noted the objective to acquire Ravna cannot be fulfilled. How to treat the lab and D has been discussed. All studies ended sometimes later. Rumored as one man has taken the resource data and disappeared. Then comes the end sequence. And yes, that's D's run.